part 2, chapter 27 of Little Women is called Literary Lessons. Jo is writing a novel and shuts herself up in her scribbling suit to fall into her writing vortex. During these periods, she forgets to eat and sleep, but is supremely happy. Switching from romances to thrillers, she enters a contest and wins $100. Jo decides to send Beth and Marmy to the seaside for a few months. Then, her novel is also accepted by a publisher, although he wants her to make a lot of cuts. She takes everyone else's advice about revisions and ends up publishing to mixed reviews. Nevertheless, she earns $300 for it. In chapter 28, Domestic Experiences, Meg and Mr. Brook's blissful married life is not without its trials. Mr. Brook unexpectedly brings home a friend for dinner, while Meg is in the middle of her first canning fiasco and cannot accommodate him. Meg ends up apologizing. Then Meg overspends on clothes and buys expensive material to make a dress. Mr. Brook forgoes a new winter coat. Meg repents and sells the material to Sally so she can buy the coat. After the couple is married a year, Meg delivers twins, a boy and girl nicknamed Demi and Daisy. In chapter 29, Calls, Amy brings Jo with her on a round of social calls, which Jo hates. At one house, Jo doesn't speak at all. At another, she's excessively social and imitates one of Amy's friends. Amy tells Jo that women should learn to be agreeable, particularly poor ones, for they have no other way of repaying the kindnesses they receive. Aunt March's house, Jo shows her most ornery side. She doesn't realize her aunts, Aunt Carol is visiting Aunt March, are deciding which sister will go to Europe, and Jo effectively takes herself out of the running. The theme of woman as artist continues when Jo puts on her scribbling suit and descends into a vortex. Her family asks her if genius burns, which symbolizes the artistic flame in Jo's brain, as well as the fact that the act of creation takes passion and burns the artist, being both a pleasure and pain. The narrator now indicates that genius is not required to justify a woman's art. Curiously, the happiness Jo experiences in her act of creation is much more vividly and convincingly described by Alcott than marital happiness.